We see them almost every day, in the garden, in wood piles, even in our own homes. Spiders occupy nearly every niche in nature, but few get the same reaction as the black widow. This project began when I stumbled across an unexpected friend while working in the yard.
Hey guys, I think I found a black widow in here.
This was too good of an opportunity for me to pass up. A quick look at the phylogenetic hierarchy of black widows shows they belong to the genus Latrodectus, which consists of 30 different species across the world. When I first set up the cinder block, I expected immediate action, but instead got hours of shots of a motionless spider. After a few attempts at filming, with a little help, I transferred her to a jar and set up a time lapse overnight, which was again unsuccessful. I needed something I could shoot from all angles and found it in a betta fish tank. Over the next few days, she began constructing her web. Black widows have some of the strongest silk of any arachnid and build webs of erratic appearance, having no particular form. Their silk is secreted from glands inside the spider spinneret shown here. My first few attempts at feeding failed with minor interest from the spider. I soon realized that during most of the day she never left her spot, hanging upside down on her web, and then became active at night. To test this, I set up my camera after sunset, and sure enough, she left her motionless state. She uses her silk to entangle her prey before injecting a neurotoxic venom from her chelicerae to permanently disable it. Although black widows have a nasty reputation, they are generally timid and will only bite in self-defense. Only about 1% of bites on humans ends up being fatal. Since spiders can't digest solid foods, she injects digestive enzymes, which breaks down the tissues of the prey. She then sucks up the liquefied remains. Thank you. the next day, she slowly fed from her prey with minimal breaks.